Welcome to a video on solving radical equations. This video will focus on solving equations with one radical. There's a second video that deals with solving radical equations with two radicals. So here are the steps we'll follow to solve this type of equation. Number one, we will isolate the radical on one side of the equation. Then we're going to raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index. Then we will solve and then check our solutions. And the reason it's so important to check our solutions this time is some solutions may not work, and these are called extraneous solutions. Now you may be asking yourself, why would we raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index? Well, if you have the square root of x, which has an index of 2, and you square it, this would just equal x. Squaring and square rooting are opposite operations, so these two undo each other, leaving us with just x, which obviously makes solving the equation much easier. The same thing is true for any index. If we have the cube root of x and we cube it, this is just equal to x. So let's go ahead and try a few of these equations. Number one, the square root is already isolated. Remember, the square root has an index of 2. So what we'll do is we'll square both sides of the equation and then solve for x and check. Again, if we square the square root of x minus 7, this will give us x minus 7, which must equal 11 squared, which is 121. Add 7 to both sides. We have x equals 128. We can go ahead and check this. Does the square root of 128 minus 7, that's 121, equal 11? And it does, so it checks. On number two, we need to add 7 to both sides to isolate the square root before we square both sides. So if we add 7 to both sides, we would have the square root of 3x plus 2 equals positive 7. I always like to put the index in here just to remind me that I'm going to square both sides. So the square root of 3x plus 2 squared will be 3x plus 2 equals 7 squared, that's 49. Subtract 2 on both sides. That would give us 3x equals 47. Dividing by 3, we have x equals 47 thirds. Now you might think that's going to be hard to check, but look what happens when you sub in 47 over 3, and then you multiply by 3. Those 3s are going to simplify out, so this would become 47 plus 2. Which is 49, the square root of 49 would be 7 minus 7 equals 0, so this checks as well. Let's go ahead and try a couple more. Again, the first step here is to isolate the radical, or in this case, the cube root. So we should add 8 to both sides. Next, this 2 is attached by multiplication, so we should divide both sides of the equation by 2. So we have the cube root of 5x minus 1 must equal 4. Now our index is 3, so we'll raise both sides of the equation to the power of 3. The cube root of 5x minus 1 cubed will just be 5x minus 1 equals 4 to the third power will be 64. So we'll add 1 to both sides. That would become 65. Divided by 5, x equals 65 divided by 5 would be 13. And we can go ahead and check this as well. 2 times the square root of 5 times 13 would be 65 minus 1, that'd be 64 minus 8 equals 0. And again, this is the cube root. So the cube root of 64 would be 4. So 2 times 4 is 8 minus 8 is 0. Checks. And let's take a look at one more. Remember, before we start, we must isolate the square root, so we're going to subtract 6 on both sides. So we'll have the square root of x equals x minus 6. It's a square root, so we'll square both sides of the equation. We're not squaring each term, we're squaring both sides. So on the left, we're going to have x, that's good. On the right, we actually have to multiply this out. X minus 6 times x minus 6. Remember, you can't just square x and square 6. So we have x equals, this would be x squared, minus 6x minus 6x minus 12x, plus 36. Okay, we have a quadratic equation now, so we're going to set it equal to 0 and see if we can factor it. So if we subtract x on both sides, we're going to have 0 equals x squared minus 13x plus 36. I believe this is factorable. Factors of x squared, x. Are there factors of 36 that add to negative 13? And there are. Negative 4 and negative 9. Okay, so it looks like we may have two solutions, either x equals 4 or x equals 9, but let's go ahead and check these to make sure. Let's check x equals 4 first. We'd have the square root of 4 plus 6 equals 4. Well, this doesn't work. That would be 2 plus 6 equals 4. That's not true, which means this is one of those extraneous solutions, so we cannot include that as a solution. Let's go ahead and check x equals 9. So we have the square root of 9 plus 6 equals 9. And this looks pretty good. This would be 3 plus 6 equals 9. That checks. So we do have one solution. But this is a prime example of why it's so important that we do check our answers. Okay, the next video will deal with solving these types of equations when you have two radicals instead of just one. Thank you for watching. I hope you found it helpful.